Welcome back, guys, to another video. This is Hacking Figures, and this is going to be a review on the Mego Leatherface from the remake of the Texas Chainsaw Massacre movie. So let's fucking go. So here he is, Leatherface from Mego, and this is from the 2003 remake of Texas Chainsaw Massacre. You know what? It's funny because like I remember this came out when I was in high school, and I remember going seeing it with my buddies and absolutely fucking hating the movie. It came nothing close to the original. But as I got older and more recently, I started watching it again, and I absolutely loved the film. You know, they did the best that they could for that movie. You know, it's hard to remake absolutely classic movies. So I think they did a good job on that movie, and that's all I'm gonna say about that. But so this is a cool action figure, and yes, Mego is back. I'm glad because the first couple waves were a lot of like TV shows from the 70s and the 80s, and they didn't make too many horror action figures. I did pick up like Dracula when they came out with Dracula, and I think like Frankenstein, the Wolfman, but they started coming out with like Freddy Krueger and shit like that. So when they released this Texas Chainsaw Massacre Leatherface, and I saw the picture, I was like, I have to fucking get it. And I got this last week at Frankincense. I bought this actually at Video Shock. And yeah, this is pretty cool. So let's look at this packaging here. It comes in a typical, it has like a card back here. And he comes in a little bubble. And you can see in his accessories, he just comes with his chainsaw. And the only thing I don't like about these Migos is like their hands. They just come with like a relaxed hand. So I got a feeling that he's not really gonna grip and hold that chainsaw. But we'll see when I crack him open. And yeah, so let's check out the art here. You have like the cover on the top of the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. And you have a picture of him and how he looked in the film. And he looked fucking brutal. He looked like a fucking a pro wrestler, if you ask me. And flip it to the back here. And of course, the same thing. You have the Texas Chainsaw Massacre and a photo of Leatherface here. And yeah, so you have the Mego logo. And then you have Marty Abrams. And he's the father of Migos, I guess. But yeah, so that's it. So let's crack them open, and I already know how these Migos are, but let's crack them open so you guys can check out his articulation and stuff and see how these Migo figures are. So let's check it out.
Let's go over this articulation here. So some people that might not know. So here he is here, and so his head does rotate, goes all the way around in a circle if you wanted him to, and his arms go all the way around. You can see that there, and the elbows kind of stiff, but the elbows do bend. So you can see right there that the elbows do bend, and put it back down. There's a wrist articulation. You can see there some wrist articulation. It's a little blurry. Sorry about that. So he does have a little bit of waist articulation. His legs go up so he can sit down if he wanted to. Knees bend, so you can see that his knees do bend, and the legs do have articulation. But what I like about these, look, you can kind of see that they have actual like boots on, and it's not part of the figure. And some of the see, these are boots that go all the way up, so it's gonna be hard to take that off. But some of these figures come with just like regular shoes, and they come off, which is pretty cool, I think. And so yeah, so that's Leatherface there, standing there. And just as I expected, the hands are relaxed, but they're tight enough where I could squeeze this in. And there you go. And he can hold the chainsaw there pretty good. It stays. But yeah, so let's put him in some action shots and let's check it out. So here's a size comparison so you guys can check out Leatherface here. And so here's a NECA retro style Leatherface. And there he is right there. And this one's actually one of my favorite ones. But yeah, so there he is, stands right next to him. So here's a Mezco Leatherface Cinema of Fear next to the Mego. And these are actually supposed to be the same character from the same movie. So you can see like the different style detail in these figures. And here's another NECA. This is an old school NECA. And this is from the Texas Chainsaw Massacre as well, box set. So there's that figure to go with it. And just for the fun of it, there's a mini muscle horror figure of Leatherface for the first Texas Chainsaw Massacre. And he goes up about to his knee, or just about to his knee level. And this is just for fun, so you can see the size comparison. He's about the size of an old school muscle man from the 80s.
Thanks again, you guys, for checking out this video. If you're new to this channel, hit that fucking subscribe button right fucking now. Make sure you guys hit that like button as well. Leave a comment. Tell me what you think of that Mego. Do I have any Mego collectors out there? Do you guys like the Megos? I know a lot of people don't like the Mego style, especially like the NECA ones. So if you guys don't like those, you might not even like these Mego ones. Leave a comment down there. Tell me what you guys think. And yeah, that's it for this video. And I hope to see you guys on the next one, you guys. So peace the fuck out.